the amazing Mr. Strauss podcast.
To infinity and beyond.
For July 22nd, on this day in Disney history. On this day in 1955, the Rockett to the Moon attraction makes its debut in Disneyland's Tomorrowland.
Welcome aboard, friends. This is Captain Collins. For the next few moments, it's going to be a bit noisy, so I won't try to speak to you again until we pass through the sonic barrier, where we'll leave the roar of our rockets far behind.
Tower to Captain, rocket ship Star of Polaris. You've been cleared for takeoff.
Roger. All set, Tower.
Seated in a circular theater with screens above and below,
acting almost as windows,
guests blast off in a simulated ride to the moon, watching their journey from its departure from Disneyland on the lower screen up to the moon on the upper screen.
Attention, please. That was the breakthrough. We've passed the sonic barrier. Our altitude is now 25,000 feet, and our rate of climb has reached 1,000 feet per second.
An iconic rocket, the Moonliner, stood outside, towering over the attraction building. In 1966, the opening of an all-new Tomorrowland brought a newly updated version of the attraction called Flight to the Moon.
Welcome aboard, ladies and gentlemen. This is your captain speaking. During our flight, I'll select pictures from television cameras mounted outside our spacecraft and put them on various screens in your cabin. We're on final countdown now, so I won't be speaking to you again until we're well on our way.
By 1975, after astronauts actually set foot on the moon, the updated attraction sent guests to explore the Red Planet in Mission to Mars.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome aboard our McDonnell Douglas DC-88 space liner for today's mission to Mars.
Attention, please. Folks, this is Third Officer Collins speaking. I'm your tour guide today, and I'll be telling you about what's going on during the trip. Right now, we're on final countdown, and you can watch our liftoff on the lower screen in your cabin. I'll speak to you again after we're in space.
The last Mars flight departed in November of 1992. Today, the location is home to Red Rocket's Pizza Port, with a scaled-down replica of the original Moonliner out front. Although the technology of Flight to the Moon and Mission to Mars eventually became outdated, at the time, guests thought they were simply out of this world.
We have just landed at Disneyland. We were very happy to have had you aboard. We hope you enjoyed your TWA rocket flight and that you will be flying with TWA again soon. This is your captain signing off.